Okay, Impala Wagon fans, welcome back. Hey, it's Gene here as usual. And let's see, I already completed the drum brakes and ran the brake lines. Now I'm gonna do the emergency brake. And let's see, I'm going to take it apart, clean it up, reassemble it, and let's get it installed and adjusted. So stay tuned, here we go.
All right, here's my next challenge with these brakes. Get this all de-rusted and do some thread repair. See if I can find that spring to replace it. If not, we'll see if it's good enough. This cable goes away because I have a new one. And then I have that, adjuster cable that goes on there. So, a little bit of cleanup here to do before I can finish these brakes. Okay, let's see if we can bend these up without breaking them. Okay. There's that one. Okay, and there's that one. Okay. Now we gotta get these two bolts out. Spin this over. Update the camera. Okay, I gotta get this bolt out. This guy right there. So let's play around with that. Wow. If I get that off, there'd be a miracle. Let's use that hacksaw and cut that off of there. Not sure if I turned the camera back on, but I got that off. There's two bolts off of there. That's off. Cable's removed. Now we'll take this piece and get it. I cut the bolt off with the hacksaw. And now I'm gonna get that nut off of there. I think. Thank you. Came off easier than I thought. Okay. That's junk. We gotta clean that up. Let's see, we use some cotter keys. Alright, let's straighten this mess up and get parts cleaned up. Okay, got these all painted up, ready to put back together. All right, let's see if we can get this thing back together. Got a picture on my phone. Let's see, let's start off with this guy. Let's see if it's the right length. Old one, new one. Other end, same size. Cool. That's something, right? Okay. Nice and loose, ready to put up underneath the car. All right. That's it. Well, there it is laid out. Now let's see if I can set up the GoPro and show you how I'm going to hook this up. All right, let's give it a try. Well, I don't know if you'll be able to see this, but I will try to show it to you. Okay, these guys got to go on first. So they go like this and like that. Okay, let's see, is this all the way on? Yep, looks good, looks good. Now let's start from the other side. Oh, just hitting my camera.
Now, don't bump the camera. It has a washer up there. I don't think so. Oh, it's sitting there nice. I'm gonna set it in there. And then go check the picture. So I believe it goes just like that. Could be totally upside down. And I'm upside down, so I believe that's correct. Yeah, I know, I'm a dumbass. Shut up. Through those things, up to here, this baby's on there. Now, here comes the hard part. I thought that I would be able to just go like this. Let's sit there for a minute. Then we'll go check the picture. It's not tight. I think once this is pulled up, it'll be fine. Besides that, it looks good. Okay. How many times did I hit the camera? I'm pretty sure that's right. I'm going to bend that over a little bit. Go back later and finish it. This pole is going to straighten it up. So let's go with that for now. This is right. Going through the right holes. We're not crossed over. Nope, they're not crossed over. I think we'll come back and get these guys bent down.
Okay, so this is what I have. I have the, let's back this thing out a little bit. Okay, so that's the emergency brake setup from my 64 Impala coupe. And it's not in bad shape. And here's the one for the wagon. And it's rusty and crusty. So it looks almost exactly the same. The only thing different is this handle is a little teeny bit different, but everything else is the same. So I'm gonna go ahead and change it out, clean this one up, and then change it out. Wish me luck. Okay, so up underneath the dash, there's one bolt screw. It's really a screw, a 7/16 screw that goes up underneath the dash. Piece of cake to get to, and those are the two that I just took off the firewall you saw. So yeah, it's really easy to get off. So let me clean this up and stick it back in there. Well, let's clean this one up and stick it in there to replace the crusty one. Yeah, that rubber thingy's missing on both of them. Shoot. So it goes right there. See that hole? That's what it looks like. But it's all messed up, broke off. All right, let's see if this little switch works. Okay, so when the cable is in there, it's adjusted. So when you let the brake off, it should push the button and open the switch, right? So when the brake's set, that should close the switch. Let's check. Okay, it's closed. So then when you let off the emergency brake, it pushes this button. Well, it works. Cool. Well, it's all oiled up, greased up. Man, it moves smooth. Feeling good. Nice, very nice. Okay, let's see if we can get this cable in there.
Right? Oh, looks like it's hitting up here at all. It's weird. Shouldn't hit that. Even when it tightens up, it'll pull it back some. course, this wheel might be a little bit longer than the other one. Okay.
Let's figure out what we need here.
I see the grommet's messed up. I think it's gonna last.
Well, that's the way it goes. A little funky, but we'll deal with it. Okay, I'll probably be in the way of the camera doing this. Let's see. Yeah, maybe a little bit. We'll see. Let's get this shit out of the way. Let's get this shit out of the way. If I lose it, never find it again. Okay. Now. Might have to move the light. I can't see. Is that better? Might be in the way of the camera, but hey, let's just go for it. Where's my new motor? Thought I brought them. That screw coming out. Bolt, whatever you want to call it. It's fun doing this upside down. I don't mind telling you. Come on, get in here.
Got it.
Probably saw my head.
Put this bad boy back together.
How'd that go in there?
Okay, I didn't get a good shot of this underneath the dash, but I want to show you how I installed the cable into the parking brake slash e-brake, whatever we're calling it. So when you go to put the cable on, which goes into this part right here. The cable slides in there. You have to take this off. This screw comes out. Pull this off. Put the cable in here. And then reinstall this before you mount it up to the firewall. So there's a couple of shots of me doing that that's hard to see because my head's in the way and the light's in the way and everything else, but that's how you do it. The switch mount has to come off first, then the cable can go in. So thought I'd show that since I couldn't show it under the dash. So there you go. Battery's almost dead. You want black ones or you want red ones? They don't want red.
Pretty cool. It works. Handle works. It's not hitting that switch yet. Like I said before, until there's tension on the cable, it'll pull this lever over and it'll hit it. And I'll work on that next.
Okay, it's released. So let's take a little bit up on this one. I feel like I like to get a little more on this one. A little bit loose, but that's okay. Let's we'll do a final adjustment when we get the brakes done, or when the car's moving anyways. Okay, let's go give it a try.
It's grabbing, but not enough. So why don't we leave it with pressure on it? We want to leave pressure on it, even when it's released.
Okay, now pressure on it, even when it's released. Not too much. We don't want to spin that. Really don't want to knock the jack stand out from under the car.
Okay, let's release it. Make sure the wheels will turn. Okay, all I gotta do is double nut this and get it over with for now.
This is a little floppy. So if I tighten this one up, we'll pull that back, but we want that to go forward a little. So why don't we tighten that one up? I don't want that floppy. It's too floppy. I could probably get it tightened up a little bit.
We're going with it. We're going with it for now. I am happy. Happy. The only issue will be is if when I get this down on the ground, if it doesn't roll good, then I can adjust it. Okay, emergency brake is released. Let's see if I can turn this. Okay, that'll turn. Obviously it won't turn when it's set because I've already tried that, so I'm good to go. All right, my people, looks like the brakes are pretty much done. Let's see, I ran the brake lines front to back. Did the drum brakes, which was kind of a challenge, but yeah, I got it. Did the emergency slash parking brake and got that to the point where it's pretty much adjusted. I'll do the final adjustments on those when it's down on the ground and rolling. I still got to complete the master cylinder booster and then those front brake lines that go to the disc brakes, but I have to do that after I test fit the engine, make sure everything has clearance. But yeah, I'm feeling real good about it. I'm ready to move on to the fuel system. So I've got some work to do on that, or modify the fuel tank, run some AN6 lines, some steel lines and things like that. But feeling really good about progress and ready to move on to the next challenge. So stay tuned for the next video. Let's go get them.